Hello, I am Myles Cupp of the Kron Rapier Study Group. I'm here with my study group partner, Sarah Trott. This week we will be continuing our series of Alfieri by looking at plate number 9. This plate is entitled On Wounding to the Outside in Seconda with a Pass of the Left Foot Under the Opponent's Sword. In this plate, we will be looking at, as what Alfieri calls, how a single mistake can lead to a great advantage for the opponent in fencing. We will be comparing this plate as well to one of the plates that we have previously looked at, plate number 7, and talking about some of the differences that we have noted in studying this plate between plate number 9 and plate number 7. So, with that said, let's start interpreting the plate. For this play, I will be gentleman number 17 and Sarah will be gentleman number 16. We have both arrived in measure in terza to the outside, and I am going to provoke Sarah with a feint in seconda, like so. She is going to respond to this feint by going into obedience and pushing her sword forward and forth, right, raising her hilt up, but she is not threatening me as she should with a proper counter, parry, and thrust in tempo like Alfieri says she should do. So in this instance, I would still miss her with the lunge, but she has not threatened me with any kind of counter. I can use this counter in order to do all kinds of things against her. Alfieri gives 3 ways that I can wound her. So, elaborating on what we have just seen, I am going to again provoke gentleman number 16, Sarah, with the feint in seconda to the outside that she responds to by pushing her hilt forward in a fourth like is shown in the plate. Showing that once more and now with the complete action. I feint, she goes for that obedience. As soon as she goes for that obedience, I cavazione and execute a pass, seizing her hilt and lunging under her sword in seconda. Doing that once more with a little bit more vigorous tempo. And once again. So, Alfieri says that the cavazione to strike gentleman number 16 should be done in the instant that gentleman number 16 has been put into obedience by performing an incorrect parry, which is simply to have raised the hilt forward without presenting any kind of counterattack, any kind of counter thrust, or bringing the point online that would make me think twice about performing such a vigorous action. One thing that we noted when we were studying this play is that this is a very similar feint, if not an identical feint, to the one that is described in plate number 7, which you can review in our previous videos. In that particular plate, we again performed a feint in seconda over the opponent's sword, but in that case, the opponent's parry was a wide parry to the outside. So, I feint and the opponent performs the wide parry to the outside. In that particular instance, Alfieri described a different reaction. He said instead that once the feint has been performed and the opponent goes for the wide parry, to lunge underneath in second and recover quickly. So reviewing the action from plate number 7 once again, I feinted, opponent goes for a wide parry, I strike and recover very quickly. We think that this particular parry is different than the one described in plate number 7, mostly from looking at the image itself. In the image, it looks more like the opponent has simply pushed his hilt forward without presenting a threat to gentleman number 17. So that is one of the ways in which we noted that that is the reason why this action is different than the one in plate number 7. The parry performed is a different one, a different kind of obedience. The second way that Alfieri describes wounding the opponent is an attack in line A over the opponent's sword after performing the feint. Once again, I provoke the opponent with the feint in seconda, to which gentleman number 16 responds with the parry that does not present the threat by pushing the hilt forward as previously described. In this particular instance, I will still again attack with a pass of second, but this time I attack with a pass in line A. Demonstrating once again, I have feinted. The opponent goes for the parry. And I have hit in line A. Demonstrating once more. Feint, parry, pass, and hit in line A. The third play that Alfieri describes that this action can take is to, again, provoke the opponent with a feint in seconda over their sword like so, which they respond to by being put into obedience, raising their sword up without presenting a threat. In response to this, I can now execute my pass and attack under the opponent by performing a mandrito along line B to the opponent's lead leg, in which I pass, seize, and mandrito to the lead leg. Performing that action once again. Feinte seconda, parry, pass, seize, mandrito to the lead leg. Demonstrating once again with a little bit more vigor. Demonstrating once again. And once more. So that is what we think the third variation is that Alfieri describes. Passing under the opponent's sword against an opponent who has parried without presenting a counter threat, and answering with a seizing of the blade and a mandrito along line B to the leading lower leg. We hope you have enjoyed this interpretation of Alfieri's plate number 9. I am Myles Cupp of the Kron Rapier Study Group, here with my study group partner, Sarah Trott. Like I said, we hope you have enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time. Thank you very much.